Hello there, my name is Mitimbe Thomas Chuma, and I'm the Son of Karma. Welcome to the Son of Karma podcast. Today is Sunday, so we're doing church and stuff, and I have two guests in the podcast. Would you please introduce yourself, sir?
Hi, my name is Amos, and I'm a Christian, of course, yeah.
That's it?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay. And I am Tyron Zega. It's my second time here on Church and Stuff. I'm so glad to be here.
Okay, that sounds... You can still sound like an idiot. just calm down and breathe.
I can't. Okay.
It's fine.
Cool.
Yeah, I got it. Yeah. So, we're gonna cut into it. That's what I'm gonna say. So almost, I want to ask, what does God mean to you?
A lot of people, right, when they ask these kind of questions, the questions itself, they are really weird. Sometimes you can't even imagine, if that question, who is God, it's a very difficult question. Yeah, but anyway, as for us as Christians, you know, the Bible explains to us that we should be ready to give answers to whatever question that we might be asked.
Yeah.
So as to me, when I ask myself, who is God? God is everything about me. He's my life. He's the most important thing that can ever happen to me. And without even using any scripture, I can really say that God is my life. Yeah.
I'm not putting you on the spot,
Ned. But then
you can't
feel any pressure. Well, actually, I love what you said. But then, to me, I was going to give a very simple answer. I was going to say God is the Father. And then that one is all what I'm going to say.
That's a great answer.
That's a great answer.
Ah, because it's not like it covers all the bases.
Yeah, you get to think of it in a more different way than...
Yeah.
Yeah, because I feel like we should be comfortable asking questions like this as Christians. Yeah, because the atheist, and I don't know if anyone has ever argued with an atheist before, and
yeah,
they slash you down very fast.
they have everything to clash you with. If you're not very deep into this,
if you don't have your ducks in a row, they'll cut you down very fast. They don't play.
Exactly. I once watched an interview of some atheist, and then this guy, and it was really, really not good.
Yeah.
The questions he was asking, they were really strong and personal.
Maybe I should read the Bible more.
Yeah, true.
I think I'm gonna download the audio version of the Bible.
Really?
Yeah. Because I realized that the amount of stuff that I listen to, I'm always playing music, I'm always listening to podcasts, and maybe if I get an hour in there, it'd be nice to wake up, yeah?
Because for me, for reading, right now,
mm,
I have a lot of novels that I always say, I need to read this.
Yeah.
And then reading for me, I'm struggling with this other book that you're supposed to be reading. And then I think I'm on page maybe 80. We're supposed to be on page 220 today.
Yeah. Somewhere there. And I've discovered, you know, a lot of people think it just has to be I just have to read the Bible and know it. But the Bible is not all about reading, actually. It's about understanding it and receiving it inside. The Bible is far much different from other books, right? I'm sure all of us know it.
Yeah.
It itself like contains some information. Of course, we can find it in other books, but that information that is in it, it is really powerful, and it really works wonders. And as I can give an example for my life, I have seen the Bible working in my life. What I just have to do is, if I approached it wanting to have knowledge, it's good, but it's not the best. If you want to understand the Bible very well, you approach it looking for Jesus. Yeah. And that's the most important thing. If you read it because you want to know Jesus.
It makes it easier.
Yeah.
I think one of my biggest loops as a Christian is that this isn't the big sins. I'm not out there raping people and stuff. Like, it's just the small stuff. It's like, you know, let me change the story a bit. Change it up a bit. You know, let me take this thing. No one will notice. It's just one.
Just one.
I haven't met that anyone.
Yeah.
I think you, the son of Kaba, and me, like, you realize right now, like, you can tell that we are on these different, like, these different levels with Kaba. He talks about these things.
Yeah, he knows the stuff.
He knows the stuff.
Like, we're on.
We need to change. Don't you think so?
Eventually, I know that will change.
Really?
Like, the day and time, I'm not sure. But like, I'm slowly going into it.
But what do you mean when you say you're gonna change?
What's it like? I mean, I change, not change as in actions, but then like change as in thoughts.
Thoughts?
Because like, this is the main reason why I never, like, when people have a crisis or stuff, I never say thoughts and prayers, because I don't want to put your stuff in my thoughts. It's not safe. The things that I think about.
I think it's in all of us, really, truly, to be honest, like to be honestly speaking. Maybe a lot of people think if there are people who looks like they know the Bible well and can speak boldly about it, maybe they don't think about other thoughts. But to be honest, there are many things that we think about, and even I myself think about, that does not even line with the Bible. And I'm really trying with the help of the Holy Spirit, to make sure that I be a person that Jesus wants me to be. Because to be honest, there are a lot of things that comes to even my thoughts. I think of a lot of things, right? So thinking actually happens to everybody. Thoughts usually come. Sometimes you don't want them, but they are there. And then you just think of it.
I'm gonna say, like, if Meta was bigger, I'd probably have, maybe around 10.
Like, right now.
Like, if it wasn't, you won't go to jail.
Yeah.
Like, you just have to live with the guilt. Like, around 10. Like, it's not the big things. Like the small things.
Yeah.
Would say, like, you're in a coma. The four seater, and then the person is just like their money later, and I'm just like,
yeah.
Well, yeah, I think I like what Thomas was saying. Like, he gives us a view of people. Like, generally, we as beings, we think that once we see someone who is into spiritual things, like, we start treating them like saints or something like that. Like, we start saying, because he reads the Bible a lot, or he knows the Bible a lot, we expect them to be like, so holy. Like, we don't expect them to do the things that they're supposed to. Like, I get to see him talking to a girl, then I'm like, he also does that. Yeah. But then, they're just human. They're just human after all.
Human after all.
Let's change it up.
We're now at 30 minutes. Yes, I should have done this in the beginning. Do you have an Instagram?
Anything
that you want to shout out?
Not for now.
What's your Instagram?
My Instagram? My Instagram at Angel Amos.
Underscore.
Underscore, exactly. Angels, then underscore, then Amos.
Okay.
If there's anybody
Have you ever been followed by Illuminati?
Yeah.
I was also followed by Illuminati.
Yeah, of course. There was this witch doctor from, I think it's Ghana.
Witch doctor?
Yeah, he followed me on Instagram, and I immediately rebuked his request, but later on I decided that I should have accepted him, and then maybe we could have a chat, talk about what we believe in. I think it would be really good, because, you know, if you want to grow, or you want to know more in what you believe in, you have to face those kind of people that challenges you a lot.
Yeah, that's why I talk to the Muslims.
Yeah. What do you do?
The Muslims, they don't challenge us. By the way, the thing that we were talking about last Sunday, it's called the hijab.
Alright, so it's called the hijab, and this has been changing stuff. I'm Muslim Tyron. See you tomorrow. Myself, I'm on a solo. Thank you very much. It's a Son of Come podcast. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.